RadioColusa.com.
Time, weather, and
highways.
Pass. Case of.
It's time for an episode of the Backpage,
a weekly podcast where you'll hear from your hosts,
Lloyd, Kent, and Hayley,
as they cover their favorite hot topics in the greater Colusa County area.
Heck,
you might even hear an opinion or two.
Now.
It is now time.
It's now time
for the Backpage.
For the Backpage.
It's time for the Backpage.
We're here live at the Colusa County Fair.
Yeah!
Woo!
Thanks everybody for joining
Thank
us.
Thank you so much for wait.
I was so glad they booked Journey this year.
I know.
One of my favorite bands. I'm sad REO and Styx is not here with them, but
well,
we are patiently waiting for the next event. What's coming up next, Lloyd?
We are not at the Colusa County Fair. It's not happening.
Oh, are we?
Wake up, Cam.
Are we not?
Wake up. Open your eyes.
Wake up.
Not a real fair corn dog.
We would be if we were having a fair this year, but
What would have been fair week?
I mean, they should have had the theme this year instead of barn in the USA, recycled from the failure last year.
Barn in the USA? Yeah. Is that the theme?
That's the theme. They should have done like not the fair. So like it'd have been not the fair of 2021. It's
and they could have had the little baby from the show. Remember the show with the show dinosaurs?
Yeah.
Yeah. Not the fair.
Mama. Yeah. Not the mama. Not the fair.
And he could hit somebody with a pan.
There you go.
Gosh.
Yeah. You don't remember that
a
show.
A gavel.
You're too
because
young.
It's animal watched, auctions.
No, you don't. Yes, I did.
Well, the kid, the 4-H.
You were like 2 when that show came out.
Whatever, Kent.
No, she probably been at 3.
Yeah.
The show used to be on Disney.
No.
The reruns.
Oh, then I watched the reruns.
It was on like ABC, bro. It was syndicated. No.
Yeah,
not syndicated.
I think it was later on, like Nickelodeon or what's that other one?
Nick at Night?
Cartoon Network. Anyhow. So, yeah, no Colusa County Fair this year, but the kids are out there. They're selling their animals.
It's like a mini fair. They've got the kids doing the animals.
No, you can't call it a fair if there's no exposition. Otherwise, it's an animal auction and sale.
The animals don't count as expositions?
No.
Why not?
Because fairs are generally showcasing your works.
But
your
the 4-H kids are.
So that's not work?
Not out there.
I thought they, did they open, well, yeah, I don't know. I'm not going to start stuff.
Sherry Azevedo and Maxwell held a exposition for the 4-H kids.
So I thought that maybe they were just going to open a hall for the only the 4-H kids to put their stuff on display for judging.
To my knowledge, that is not happening.
Okay.
It is only Sherry. It actually already happened in this week's paper. We covered it. There was a 2-day, I think it was June 3rd and 4th. They had Sherry Azevedo at the, what is that? The Maxwell Legion Hall.
Okay.
They had the 4-H kids submit their stuff and they got awards for best photography, food, table arrangements, all the stuff that they would normally have at the fair.
Mm-hmm.
But this year they chose not to do any of that. So. It is just an animal auction and a derby on Saturday. No matter how you want to call it, it is not the fair.
There's food vendors.
There are food vendors.
Whoop-de-doo-da. Anybody can pull out a food truck. I mean, honestly.
There's no carnival rides.
There's no carnival. There's no expositions.
Which I've been watching videos lately.
Yeah, stay off of those.
I don't think I'm ever going on a carnival ride ever again.
I never will.
Holy.
I don't like carnival rides.
There's some like devastating accident. Like, people die on those things.
As they would say, you know, that's one in a million.
I'm not usually that kind of person, but I mean.
Yeah. Well, you know, most of the time.
I know.
Some of those equipment, not now, this isn't every.
Does the county, like, when they come to Colusa, because so, let me start over. You know, I've seen on the news, the state fair.
Yeah.
Those rides are set up weeks in advance.
Oh, weeks,
and they
yeah.
have gone through, like, testing and review, like they are they're good to go. Inspection, that's what I'm looking
review.
For.
Review.
I don't know. Inspection review. Does anyone all do that?
All the local columnists come in and give them thumbs up or thumbs down. Fairs,
well, they usually do. They come in and they set up like week before?
Oh, they set up the night before, Lloyd. They'd like hours before the doors open. Let's be honest.
True.
You've seen how fast that Ferris wheel goes up. I'll drive here and then on my way home, like 2 hours later, it's like up and spinning around. Like
I'm sure they have some kind of internal type of a thing. I don't know if the fairgrounds does that or if the actual vendor of the carnival,
whatever they're called. Those things are designed to go up pretty quickly. Like they probably just have a couple pieces that fold out, throw in a couple cotter pins, and you're good to go.
That sounds really safe. Yeah, that
sounds safe at all, you know?
I'm just saying, like
some WD-40.
Oh, that's what that
for the spots
is.
That stick and won't, or the spots that stick and should move is WD-40, and the spots that move and should stick is duct tape.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
But anyhow,
and if it rattles, don't worry about it. That's just part of the ride.
I guess everybody likes to have fun, you know. That's the whole fun of it, just not knowing if.
Hey, I go on the rides. Well, I used to.
Oh God!
Now it's only the big slide.
I was traumatized from a kid. Not never going to go back on
another
one again.
Only the big slide.
Only the big slide. All the kids ask me, go big slide. If it's not there, then no ride. Or I'll go sit on the merry-go-round.
What'd you go on last time? The octopus that one year? Is that the one you went on? You're like, oh, I'm going on that. I'm like, yeah, okay.
Oh, dear God.
And then she gets so sick afterwards. And then I took her on the Ferris wheel and she couldn't even handle the Ferris wheel at that point. And I start rocking the Ferris wheel while we're on top.
Oh no.
And she's punching me and knock it off.
The worst ride to go on with my mother would have been like the teacup or whatever that is. You know,
the little like scrambler thing.
Oh yeah. She would sit there and she would just pull on that big old wheel in the center and just spin you around.
Yeah. Nope.
No,
nope.
Thank you. I don't know.
Tell you about that time we met Jack Black on the teacups.
You met a Jack Black?
No, the Jack Black.
Well, we didn't meet him. We saw him.
He waved. It counts.
Also, this wasn't at the disclosure. This was not at the Colusa County Fair.
Or was it?
This was at Disneyland.
Ah. So, it's a possibility.
Hayley met Kobe Bryant.
But there's no, we'll save this story for another. If anybody cares to know my story, I will tell them in person. But I had a drink with Kobe Bryant.
There's photo evidence.
We locked eyes, so I can say Kobe Bryant has seen me. He knows I exist in the world because we locked eyes and I sipped my drink when he sipped his drink. And I was like, that's it. That's all I needed.
That's it. We did actually legit.
He is tall, by the way.
A real honest to God conversation back and forth, talking, shaking hands, the whole works with Curtis Armstrong. Yeah, I was going to tell her that.
Yeah, I know. They're over here writing me notes saying Kobe Bryant is dead. Yeah, I know
that. He doesn't
know
you're alive. He knew you were alive.
Okay, let me rephrase. He knew I was alive in the world.
I just can't handle that.
Anyhas. All right, enough about our dumps, but no one cares about who we've met.
Well, you talked about it on an episode before.
Yeah.
You had photo evidence, too. Yeah. So.
I think right after.
But no, like, legit, we did have a conversation. And actually shook hands and like met Curtis Armstrong. So the people out there who know who he is know who he is. People that don't, well, look him up.
I sadly Google don't. Him. See, that's the issue. We're not going to have any entertainment. There's no Miss Colusa County. There's
tonight would have been Miss Colusa County.
Yeah. Yeah, man. We haven't had a Miss Colusa County in 2 years. Next year when they have the fair, the Miss Colusa County is going to be an old woman. It's like she's going to be like 20.
Oh,
you know
my
what we
God.
Can say? I think didn't you win the funnel eating contest like the last year?
I did. I am the reigning funnel cake eating champion for 3 years. I have a medal at home to prove it.
Just like his award winning wine.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm going to enter it this year. I'm going to be the champion of 2021.
There you go.
Gold medal winner.
So good luck to the kids out there this weekend. They're going to be selling their animals.
I'm just glad they were able to go back to the arena and kind of can try to do as normal, even though there's not any rides or anything. I'm glad
they were able to sell their animals on the the fun side of things where they actually get to show the animals and be out there.
And I think that's one of the big things of the Colusa County Fair is for the kids to be able to show and sell. I mean,
that's one of the things. Because it's not always about kids. You know, there are adults, too, who go out there and exhibit all of their artwork. And
I didn't get to enter
anything. Cheesecake.
And cheesecake and cookies and brownies. And
it was raw.
Just think, you might have a chance to actually be people when it opens back
up. Yeah, you could win this year.
I could.
Just think, if the judge had COVID, they won't have any taste.
Yeah, they wouldn't know it was raw. I don't think the judge had a taste anyway.
Well,
when's the deal that you can submit stuff over at the art store?
We're going to get into that right now.
So actually, first, while you're out there at the fair auction that's going to be going on Saturday.
Hey, you said it wasn't a fair.
Well, okay, yeah.
You caught me there. I got you.
I'm reading the thing here, which is the Fair Foundation. Mm-hmm. They will be out there at the animal auction on Saturday at about 8:15 in the morning. They're going to be doing the Heritage Preservation Awards the Colusa Western Days Committee, the Leon and Francis Etchefair family, and David Zwald. They were doing a fundraiser this year, which was kind of a little weird and kind of last minute, so I'm hoping it really worked out for them. But you can submit a song and dedicate it to someone for $100, and it'll be part of a charity Spotify list that they're going to play at some of the local events. And
it's going to say their name and a sweet message?
Probably not, because I don't think that's how Spotify playlists work. However, because, you know, they could have hired us and we could have done big old long podcast episode, but next year.
We're expensive, though.
We're way too expensive. So what they're going to do is they're going to make a metal record that's going to have everyone's name and the song and who it was dedicated to. And it'll be on display for the life of the fair. So that's kind of a cool thing.
Like a vinyl record?
Kind of like, you know, how the platinum records were, hang on the wall. It'll be something similar like that. And so,
is it playable?
No, unfortunately. Lame. I wish.
Lame.
Well, there's copyright things that they had to get into and all that stuff. So anyhow, if you're interested in being part of the fair playlist, you can dedicate your song at Messix, Griff's Feed and Seed, or Osco Geyer.
No word on how many songs they're picking, right?
They didn't want a limit. At first, it was like the top 100, but that would only make them $10,000, and they really want to make more than that.
If I won $1 million, if I had $10,000, I would have bought every spot and played the same song on repeat.
Boom-bop by Hanson. Stop the bop. Don't stop the bop.
I'm like, that would have been a cool opportunity too. Because, I mean, what if, you know, Hayley dedicates Hanson Imbop and then Kent does it back to her. And then, you know, there's like 20 people who are dedicating the same song. It's like they should have done some kind of auction thing with it. So like, you know,
who would like to dedicate WAP by Cardi B?
Yeah.
The bidding starts at
$5. $5, $10, you know, and just keep going up until you get your actual price. And
who would like to dedicate Body by Megan Thee Stallion? The price begins at $15.
Oh, that should be fun. But as there is no fair going on, the Colusa County Arts Council has decided to fill that void. See, I tell you, there is no fair going on. So they're having what they're calling Fair Around the Square, or Fair in the Square. So
they're going to have items on display that people can show they made over the year?
Yeah. And it's so, okay, like,
so it's a fair.
It's going to be at Willis Green Park or the Park Hill Street Park there. People can bring out their stuff. They can put it on display. Or if you don't want to go out in the public and you want to stay home, but you want to still display it, you can display it in your yard if you live in Colusa.
What day was that again?
That is this Saturday, the 12th. And it looks like it starts at what time, Haley?
10 a.m. And it goes to 4 p.m.
Yeah, so if you got whatever you got on, you know, you made a quilt over the last couple of years, artwork.
I'm going to bring my wine.
You bring your wine?
When's the deadline to enter?
There is no deadline. You can just show up that day and enter it in. I don't even think there's a cost.
Are they giving away prizes?
No. This is right here. No, actually, no rules. No boundaries. I can't talk tonight. No judges. Just sharing all of your work. Yeah,
it's just to show your work and show off. And and then that night, speaking of things to do, they're going to have a street dance.
Street dance.
I haven't been to a street dance in a long time.
I wonder if they'll have that balloon arch.
Ooh, they did have a balloon arch last time.
So they're
in front of Hayley in front of it.
Arts Council building there on 5th and Market Street. They're going to close that off there and have another street dance. The Ma Barker Band will be there.
Who is that?
It's the one that's played in a concert in a park.
The guy that used to host Price is Right?
No, that's Bob Barker.
You're is that silly. What you said?
No, Ma.
The Ma Barker.
Oh.
The Ma.
The Bob
Ma
Barker, Barker Band.
No, Ma.
Did you know Bob Barker has a dog named Jesse? Well, probably not anymore. I'll bet Jesse's probably dead, but he had a little dog named Jesse. Fun fact.
Okay. Go show your artwork or your work or whatever you're so proud of that you want to share.
If you have the best makeup look, just sit out in your front lawn and show off your makeup. I mean, it's all an art, right?
Yeah, Mimi, you should sit out there and show them your makeup.
I should paint my nails and just sit in the park with my hand in the air.
That would be funny. Just Hayley sitting there going, look at my nails. Look at my nails.
Look at my nails.
Says no rules.
Look at them.
Look at my nails.
Let's dress up Harvey and just have him go sit at the park. Here.
The street dance is $15 to get in, and they're going to have some drinks and some...
Said food trucks, drinks, food treats. It's from 6 p.m. to 10 p.m.
So
that's on 5th and Market Street. So
should be fun.
Man, so Friday, did we talk about, well...
Oh, no, we didn't talk about the... Well, that's tonight, the fair parade.
Okay, tonight.
Yeah, doing air quotes because it's Thursday right now as we record this. So tonight, Friday, when this episode airs, is going to be the fair parade.
Yes. Okay, is it me or... I felt like there wasn't a whole lot of advertisement for... hold on. Hear me out, and then I'm going to correct myself before you bark at me.
I'm not going to bark at you.
I felt like there wasn't a whole lot of advertisement for the Colusa County Fair Parade. Yes, I would say it was in the little community events brief. It was there. That's how I knew about it. But I felt like, didn't they put a banner... Or wasn't there more advertisement for
it? Not that I'm aware of. I think usually it comes along with the fair. So it's advertised with the fair. But we like don't have a fair.
Fairgrounds didn't post anything about it.
The fairgrounds doesn't want to ever be associated with it because it's Lions Club that does it. So it's one of the things. It's your event. We don't want nothing to do with you. Talk to the hand. But they will put it on their posters when they have a fair.
Interesting.
Yeah, it's kind of one of those weird things. And I do agree. I wish there was more information.
Because a lot of people said, oh, no, it's not happening. It's not happening. I'm like, yes, it is. It's literally in the paper, like small, like this little. If you read the community events, it was. So
same font as everything. Oh.
Tiny, tiny micro. I'm just kidding.
Should be.
Barely read. But anyways, so it is happening. Yes. You've heard it here first. The streets are happening. Okay, this is what I'm confused about. Is this every year? It says the streets are closed off from 5 to 8, but the parade's not 3 hours long. It starts at 6?
6, and it's usually about an hour and a half long parade.
Is it that long?
I think sometimes they take forever. Sometimes you have,
I think it just depends on how many entries they have.
Correct.
And who, like...
I mean, this year could be tons of entries because everybody's been...
Speaking of entries, on our drive over here... There's people building floats.
Yeah.
What?
I want to say, don't quote me, unless it wasn't a float. I think Colusa Swim Team's doing one.
Oh, of course they're doing one. You know they're doing one.
I'm pretty sure I saw them.
You know they're doing
one. And
I
hope they do one. I hope everyone does a float.
Well, are you doing a float? we did the Pioneer Day. That was enough for us for right now.
Outloaded for a back page float, so... I will be on some float.
Next year, we will be something. I don't know what yet.
Why can't you just enjoy the parade? You always got to be on a float.
Because she likes waving to people.
I like watching the parade because I can see all the flows.
Then why don't you watch the parade this year?
We should have stuck a GoPro on your truck so that way we can watch it. She was happily waving to everybody like she was Miss Colusa County.
You guys heard the podcast. This one over here was waving.
Elbow, wrist, wrist.
Okay, well, it's not about me. Kiss. So, fair parade's happening. Not fair parade. The Lions Club.
Fair parade. You could call it that because that's what
Colusa
they call it.
Colusa County Fair Parade.
So yes, it's happening that on the Friday, the streets close at 5, the parade starts about 6, and it goes from, what is that?
Sac River Fire Department all the way to the end of the pool park.
Yes. Think about Sioux Street, they'll probably cut off, because usually they go down and they end at the fair and then they disperse that way, but...
Eagley Middle School. Yeah. The turnoff. Webster Street, there we go.
There you go.
Webster Street.
So
come out for that.
So there you go. Friday, parade. Saturday, you have fair in the square. You have a street dance. And then Sunday, you can go to the Destruction Derby.
Oh,
which
that's
almost sold out.
We're going. We going to be there.
We will be at the Destruction Derby.
Ken Hayley will be there.
Yep. Yes.
So we'll see you there.
Along with lots of other people. If you want to sit by us,
and they will be
early.
They will be the only ones there.
That's it. Just us. Just
if you want to sit by us, save us a seat next to yours.
All and the then tickets. I'll show up. So we have the whole stadium to ourselves.
Wow, they must be thanking you very much.
So, speaking of parades,
Pioneer Day.
Let's give a recap of Pioneer Day.
So, what'd you guys think? Our episode is up from us.
I haven't
going
listened
around.
To it yet. Hayley did without me.
I thought it was pretty good. I mean,
I knew it was going to be good while we were recording it.
I called it out since I heard it. We could have been a tiny bit more descriptive.
Yes.
Because we were talking about things and I was there, so I know, but a person who was not there probably like, who are they talking to?
And when we
had the three different angels, obviously.
Right.
And Angel was three different people, not the same person. But overall, we were the 18th float.
Yes, that was.
And there was more behind us, so I don't know how many participants there actually was. Did Susan put it in her article?
I don't remember seeing that.
So, but I would say someone asked me. I would say there was probably at least 25 parade floats.
I would say 20, 25, because I'm sure there's probably some people who
entries.
Yeah, because some people may not have shown up.
I want to say there was about 20. Because I took a sneak peek at the paper when they looked at us. It was like 20, low 20s, 20, 22, somewhere in there, I think.
But no, there was a lot of people that showed up. Man, I can't even talk today. What do I am even here?
This week.
You're
is
drunk.
Almost.
Go home.
It was good to see. My favorite thing is I love seeing all the Valley West residents out.
Compared to, you know, like this last year, them having to be locked up inside, it was awesome and just like heartwarming to see them sitting outside and enjoying the day and the people and the staff that was out there.
We get to see the community kind of come on by and it was good. Oh, so enjoyed seeing them. Like I said, just throughout the entire town for little small Williams, there was a big, big crowd that came out to watch the parade.
Next year, we'll have to try to figure out some kind of video solution so that way they can see us. Who cares about everybody else, but they can see us. What we were doing.
This year's theme was honoring hometown heroes.
And our theme?
Our theme was honoring
everyone.
Everyone's a hometown hero.
And so if you listen to our podcast as we were driving through,
it'll make more sense.
We called out,
people that we saw. Yeah. People that we knew. And then also recognize those who we didn't and by different careers and whatnot, because everybody made a sacrifice. I was talking to someone. They were like, oh, well, it kind of sounded like you look like you guys took the easy way out. It's like, well, actually, no, it was very hard. We went through and picked different people, different names. And it was like, well, we can't do that if we have to do this person. And it's like, you know what? Everybody. And I mean, honestly, I think those who picked specific things that always get picked that was almost the easy way out, was just picking those always stay true tracks of, oh, we're honoring this group, instead of honoring a more broad spectrum.
Now, if you were a group and you were honoring one of your own.
Yeah.
Then that's
perfect.
I think that's fine.
Yeah.
But.
Yeah, because everybody, like we said, everybody made a sacrifice. Everybody stepped to the challenge, no matter who they were.
Right. And everybody did it in a lot of different ways.
So who were the winners? Because we obviously didn't get a phone call.
We did not win.
I didn't think we would.
We weren't going out to win. I wasn't trying to win. First place went to, and I think her picture's in the paper, is Miss Keegan Collins.
Oh,
she
yeah.
She was, how old would you say Keegan is?
Gosh, she's only like 4?
I think she's older. I think she's like 6.
Is she in school?
I was saying she was like 12. No, I'm joking.
I don't think she's in school yet. Or is she in school yet?
She is a primary school. She's in primary school.
So TK?
No. Or you know what? I don't know how old Keegan is, but obviously she's old enough to drive a power wheel.
She's not a baby.
Yeah, she's not a 2-year-old.
I don't know. I would estimate that she's maybe like 7.
Is she that old?
I don't know.
I don't know. But
you know what?
She drove out there in a police power wheel with a
correct us if I don't know how old Keegan is, but she's a little girl. So yeah, she drove in a little police power wheels dressed up as a police officer with the blue line flag.
She got the cute factor.
So she won first place.
That was it. It was like, oh, you can't win against
that. Take notes. Next time we do a flow, we need to get like
a little kid
to like, actually, didn't that one year we did the Christmas one, we won like 2nd or 3rd place, didn't we?
Okay. So next year we're going to rob all of our little kid friends from all of our friends.
Well, that's what I'm saying. We had a bunch of little kids with us that year.
Make them all dress up.
The judges
up.
Are suckers for little kids.
There you go. We now know the success.
The secret. The secret to winning the fair the Pioneer Day Parade.
2nd place went to, was it Ramirez Family Farms? I will be completely honest. I don't know who. Yeah. I don't know what float they had.
There's no picture of them in the paper.
There's no picture.
I didn't see one that was identified. I mean, even some of the pictures that we saw online, we couldn't figure out. Because no one like identified, oh, this is such and such. And
all I can say is obviously they honored something, someone. So they got 2nd place. I'm sorry, Ramirez Family Farms out there. Please send us a picture of your float so we know who it was. Yeah. We did see everyone drive by, so I have an idea.
We probably saw your float.
But I don't know. So here's if anyone knows who Ramirez Family's Farm was, send us a picture so I know who. Because many people have asked us, even that listen to the podcast, who was it? I'm like, I could not tell you. I don't know. So.
And then 3rd place was the garage workers.
The garage workers. They honored all garage workers, which I don't know what a garage worker is.
That's what it says in the paper. We're not like we didn't make that up.
No.
Good job, Susan.
It was funny when I saw that. I was like, oh, you realize that's the garage fitness gym.
Did you call her out?
I'm now.
Now. So the 3rd place went to Lauren's garage.
Lauren Menor, right?
Yes.
Craft.
Well, yeah.
I think she goes by Lauren Menor Craft. So she does her garage. I don't think it's garage girls. I think it's just garage fitness. Fitness and nutrition. So they came out and did a flow and... theirs was cute. They all had like tie-dye matching shirts
all matching,
with the American
flags.
Weren't
you supposed to be on that?
We were matching. We had matching shirts on.
We did have matching shirts on. But they made their shirt.
We made our shirts. What the hell?
It had our faces on it.
Yeah.
Well, I had to make a choice and I chose you guys. So what are you complaining about?
Thank you.
I should have picked their flow. At least there's one.
You could have won something.
I could have been on a winning flow over here. But
then we really would have given you hell.
You would have been really.
And they did a little workout, or not workout, but they did a little push-up routine for the judges of doing.
See, we forgot to flash the judges.
Oh. Hey, you know what? We also did confetti cannons.
Yeah.
They probably took away points because we made a mess.
I don't care. I love confetti cannons.
They're the best. Would have been better if there were 3.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I was in the midst of building a migraine at that point, so.
Vertigo and whatnot.
Yeah.
But congrats to the winners and overall everyone. Like, thank you for participating
and getting involved
in your community. And I think that's just awesome. I think everyone is a winner that did it.
Yeah.
And shout out to Miss Andy Armstrong for being the Grand Marshal.
Wait, who got third place?
We already it was
Lloyd. Not third place. The honorable mention.
Oh, Williams Fire.
The back page.
Ah, in our hearts, we got honorable mention. No, Williams Fire got honorable mention this year.
Yeah. Yeah.
Which
arguably, and not just because I'm a firefighter, but did anyone else out there actually like build like a float, or was it mostly just people sitting on trailers?
When they were dressed up, yeah, the one guy dressed costumes, up as Gavin.
They had a legit, like a giant building that was the state cat. Like there was a lot of time and
John
effort gone
Cox
into that float.
With that bear suit.
And Gavin Newsom running around handing out masks to people. And
oh, that
he was funny. They did a solid job, and I was disappointed they didn't place.
But they got an honorable mention, so.
Yeah.
And I think at the end of the day, Williams Fire wasn't out there to win. They was out there to participate.
We are out there every year.
They
to
really
win.
Could have used the $300.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, well, moving on.
The lumber alone was
$3,000. To conclude Pioneer Day, just a quick wrap-up.
Did you talk about Andy? You started to mention her, but did we finish?
We talked about her. She
was a grand marshal.
She was a grand marshal.
Because she's grand and marshally.
She's done a lot for the community as far as, what would they say,
she
school
still
board.
Does. She never stops.
She's not part of CBW, but in her heart, I believe she still is.
Emeritus. CBW emeritus.
She needs a vacation. She needs to go to a faraway island and just rest for a few weeks.
So very well deserved. Fireworks.
Fireworks.
Lloyd did not go to the fireworks,
I
but
did not.
We went and
they were fireworks.
They were fireworks. They were okay.
They were just fireworks.
So hopefully everyone got to go watch the fireworks. I didn't honestly, it didn't really seem like there was a whole lot of people out there this year.
For fireworks?
Yeah.
Maybe
usually Education Village is like packed.
There was a lot of people over there.
I mean, there was people there, but not like a lot of people.
Williams graduated the week before. Uh-huh. So there's usually not a whole lot of people. There's usually a whole lot of people in town for graduation. So I think this year.
But graduation was last week because if anyone didn't know, Williams graduated a week before all the other schools, which I don't know why, but
yeah,
that's a story for another day. It was very quiet that weekend.
Wow.
Yeah. There wasn't much going on.
We were being nosy and we drove through town. We went for a cruise. I didn't see any graduation parties.
Don't be suspicious.
Whatever. So, yeah, I don't know. Anywho's.
Well, thanks to Morningstar for sponsoring those.
Yeah. Oh, and thanks Morningstar for the free hot dog at the vendor fair.
That's the only reason why you want to go for the free hot dog.
Always.
And a bag of chips.
Oh, and I saw my buddy Joe and I got myself a new wallet.
Cool. I want a tote bag.
You did?
Oh, yeah, you did. Jenna has it.
Yeah, I gave it to her. Like, what am I going to do with this? Although I scammed that game. That was so easy.
I got a water bottle, which Jenna has too.
It only had to
she has everybody's.
And she
right.
has everybody. Your pin. Jenna got all of her prizes.
She just stole it.
Sneaky Jenna.
Speaking of Jenna, she is now, we now have the pet of the week back because as we talked earlier, I think we might have mentioned it. She's now with the Colusa County Animal Control.
And she's in the paper again.
Again, third time.
Again, three out of 4 weeks.
You know what? They should do like what the firefighters do is that if they get in a paper, then they have to buy like ice cream.
For everybody.
For the animal control to be like her and Courtney.
The whole sheriff's department.
Ooh.
No. And the inmates in the jail.
No.
I don't think you know that. No.
Why not?
But we have pet of the week back.
Are they not allowed to have ice cream?
Probably not.
I'm sure they are.
But we have the little kitten here, Rita. She's an 8-week-old female kitten. Go adopt her.
Yeah, Hayley, let's get a kitten.
I will be honest. I don't do cats.
I don't do cats.
So why? Sorry.
Cats are nice, but
sorry,
no.
Sorry, little
you.
Rita. You're cute, but I just don't do cats.
She could be Harvey's best friend.
Mm.
Harvey needs a little friend. A little cat friend.
You know what? We've talked about this. Harvey doesn't need any friend. So
the flies are his friends.
So coming up next week, if you are, you have kids and you want to get them participating in swimming lessons or learn the importance of swimming lessons, the Arbuckle Parks and Recreation District is participating in the world's largest swimming lesson again on Thursday, June 17th. at the Arbuckle Pool there on Wildwood Road. There's two opportunities to participate this year at 10 a.m. and at 5 p.m. So kind of what they do, they get everybody in the pool, separated out into different age groups, and then they blow a whistle, and there's a set type of a swimming lesson that they get to learn based on their age groups.
Oh, nice.
And they do it for a particular time, and every year Pierce has participated thanks to Mary Grimmer, and it's kind of a pretty cool event. Helps bring awareness to water safety because it's hot this year and people are going to be out swimming. So
yes, yep. Indeed.
Hopefully not in canals.
Yeah. No, don't ever get in a canal. Once you get in, it's kind of hard to get
in. Oh, cool. So that's it's from 10 a.m. It starts at 10 a.m.
or is
it
10 a.m.? There's two different opportunities, 10 a.m. And 5 p.m.
Oh, I thought it was from 10 a.m. to 5 p.m.
I'm
That's a long swim lesson.
Between registration and everything, you probably want to get there a little early. It's about an hour. I think it's like 15 minutes is the actual like swimming lesson. The kids have to remain in the water for that period of time and they verify ages and all that stuff. And
it's kind of cool. Awesome. So I know we were briefly talking. So Arbuckle Pool is open. Colusa Pool is open. I know swim team's practicing. I don't know about, I've never drove through the daytime if
they have swimming lessons and stuff. I think you can find. And for Arbuckle, you'll go to the Arbuckle Parks and Recreation's website. For Colusa, I think the City of Colusa's website or going to City Hall. I'm not sure if Williams Pool's open or if it is. Yeah, it's going to be later in the year.
I haven't seen it.
I've not heard anything.
And then I've heard Maxwell Pool, I don't think it's open this year or might be open this year. Not quite sure of it, but there's been quite some contingency stuff with Maxwell Pool. Because they lost their, election this last year to help increase the fees so that way they can keep the programs running.
The bond or something?
Yeah.
Okay. I think the last two things, we just wrap up the paper and there are more events. First off, don't forget Concerts in the Park is starting.
Yes, it's actually already started.
Did it start this? It started this tonight. It's tonight, isn't it?
Last week?
They were out there last week.
So in the paper, if you want to know, we won't read them all, but there is a list of all the performers for each week of Concerts in the Park. Farmers Market is back as well. And speaking of Farmers Market, what's Thursday the 24th is the Colusa County Farm to Fork Dinner.
Oh, yeah. Are we going?
I would like to go as long as it's not like 105 degrees.
It's 105 degrees.
It's 108, I thought.
But let me see.
Maybe we can talk them into emceeing the event and we can get free dinner.
No.
Okay. Never mind.
Hard no.
Let's see. Where's my weather app? Did I miss something? What are you guys talking about?
But yes, Thursday, June 24th. Hold on.
next Thursday.
Is that next Thursday?
1 week from today. It is going to be 111 degrees.
Well, that's not Farm to Fork. Farm to Fork.
No. Oh, that's 2 weeks from today, huh?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, never mind.
Just stop. You're not even on the same page. LOL. Thursday. Let's start this over. Yeah. Thursday, June 24th, is Colusa. Was it Colusa County or Colusa?
Colusa County.
County. Farm to Fork dinner. It is dinner. Tables are set up in Veterans Park.
Correct.
And you eat dinner.
Yay!
It's dinner prepared by local restaurants.
Okay, that's what I thought.
With
local bounties.
Yeah. So there might be some grass-fed beef. There might be some
pecans.
Something made with pecans.
Some fresh eggs.
I think usually they go out and they pick lettuce out at Carter Farms or Ben Carter Farms. Benden Farms. They get all the Colusa County grown producers to participate.
Don't the O'Connells bring stuff too?
Yep. Yeah. There's peaches and all kinds of good stuff.
They got all kinds of stuff though. Yep.
Tickets are $50.
Yes.
And you can get them online.
Did you buy our tickets?
So you can get them online. You can call.
I guess we're not going if you didn't buy tickets.
Well, we'll need to get a sponsor for that. I mean, gosh, I don't know.
Yeah, the show doesn't make any money.
No one else's problem. So you can call for tickets. You can go online and buy tickets. They're there. Hope to see you out there.
That's someone else's problem. But yeah, we will plan to be out there. So,
I think that's the
pencil it in.
Little tidbit. Hopefully,
you know, ink it
we
in.
We talked about some events that people will go to.
Yeah.
And then lastly, to give a big shout out, 320 Colusa County graduates this year.
Yeah, there was quite a bit.
It has been a
I'm a little mad at Pierce High School class of 2021.
Why?
Yeah, Pierce.
They beat the class of 2004's graduation time.
What? That's what you were saying. Yeah.
Ours was like just over an hour and theirs was just under an hour. And they had more kids than us. Those brats.
Bunch of brats.
Wishing the best of luck.
And there's pictures, recaps. So if you had a Colusa High School graduate, Colusa County graduate, buy a paper and see if
it was two papers ago.
Oh, and this one.
This this has pictures from the graduation.
There's articles about the blocks and the graduation. So buy next week's paper.
Or last week's.
Buy last week's paper.
And this week.
And the week's before paper. Wait. Yeah.
You know what?
You're all confusing there, buddy.
So,
by the current paper that's on racks
there
today,
is pictures as well as the one from and highlights of graduation in the paper. So, if you had a graduate,
if your child graduated,
just shut up. I'm over it. We're done. I'm done.
Time to put Hayley to bed.
You're done. I'm over this.
Hey, listen to me. I love you.
I'm not even saying it back.
So, one announcement coming up. The Radio Colusa network that we have of all of our podcasts. We have a new podcast coming out here soon. It is the Colusa County Bookworms. It's a podcast from the Colusa County Bookworm or the Colusa Bookworm used bookstore.
Like the free library?
Yep.
Yeah.
It's friends of the Colusa County Library, and we're going to be doing a podcast with them where they'll talk about various different books, the bookworm, the activities that are going on at the library. We actually will have Stacy Costello on talking about some cool and interesting stuff. I'm excited for it. And then maybe we'll even feature some local authors and whatnot. They're going to be working on that. So listen to that same area as you listen to the show. So should be pretty cool.
I've never been into the bookworm.
Oh my gosh, you should go.
Yeah, I haven't either.
Well, do you read?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I read the paper.
I read palms.
Well, that's not the same as reading books.
I read minds.
I'll be completely honest. Ooh. I read more in the wintertime. Summer, I don't read.
I don't read a book as I like listening to the audiobooks.
I can't do that.
See, that
I fall asleep.
I cannot pay attention. Really? I'm always like, okay, well, let's rewind. And I'm like, you know what? I don't even have it. I give up.
I like either when I'm like driving or something to have an audiobook on instead of listening to music.
Nope. Puts me to sleep.
Nope.
Can't do it.
Gosh, I'm glad I can do that. I would never read.
But you know what? If there was like a hilarious combination of like, you know, Samuel L. Jackson reading a children's book, I would listen to that. Or like Betty White reads a steamy dirty novel. You know what I mean? Betty White reads 50 Shades of Grey. Like, I would totally grab that. And I would laugh hysterically. You know, so, something funny like that. Then I think I'd be fine. But if it's some random guy I don't know calmly reads Harry Potter.
It's more than that sometimes. It's not just calmly reading. Those are the boring books. Those are the ones you delete and move on. Like the ones you get and they're expressive. They've actually like sat down and read the book before they decided to narrate it. Instead of those ones that just...
Morgan Freeman would be a good one to listen to.
He would put me to sleep.
Do celebrities read the books on tape or is it just regular normal people you'd never heard of before?
Pretty much.
Mm-hmm. Regular normal people?
Yeah.
I would do celebrity books on tape. I would try that. I think that would work better.
Expensive.
But I don't know.
So that's the only announcement that I have. You guys have any other?
This is probably not exciting at all.
No.
But I finally tried The Last Stand in Willows.
What's The Last Stand?
It's a bar.
It's The Last Stand.
She went there on the way over here.
So you tried a bar.
But there's no stools. You have to stand up.
They serve food.
That's why it's called The Last Stand.
Food. So, yeah.
Wouldn't it make more sense to call it The Stand?
But it's... So, from the story... I'm not 100% on this, but from what I understand, is apparently it was the last outdoor standing bar that didn't get shut down. So I guess there used to be a bunch of bars like this that had all different names and stuff, okay. But then they started shutting them down one by one, or as they gave up their license, they weren't allowed to reopen or something. And this was like the last one that's been grandfathered in or some weird deal. I could be totally off on that, but that was what somebody told me once. And that's why it's called The Last Stand, is because...
It's technically the last stand, yeah, bar and grill.
There's nothing else like it anymore, and no more are allowed to be built or something like
standing
that.
Standing up and eating is bad for you.
As per their page, it says The Last Stand Bar and Grill, in all caps now, the last outdoor stand-up bar and grill in the state of California.
Is that not what I just said?
I would challenge that. I would challenge that. There has to be other bars that are... standing bar.
Name one.
I can't name one because I don't go to bars.
Exactly. Exactly.
We'll do some research. Hayley, get on.
You do some research. We don't care.
No. I finally tried it and it was good. It was really good.
Did you enjoy the food there? What did you have?
I just had a hamburger.
Just a hamburger.
Just a hamburger? Was it just a hamburger? The best hamburger you've ever had?
I had to get it to go.
What was on your hamburger?
No one cares. It was just a bacon burger.
Well, that changes things. It has bacon on it.
Yeah. Or did it have like a fried egg or sauerkraut?
Just a bacon hamburger.
Avocado? Turkey? We want to know the details about this hamburger.
It was a bacon hamburger. I don't know what more to say about it.
Was there mustard, mayonnaise, lettuce, tomato?
Whatever comes on a hamburger.
Pickles, onions, beets?
Lots of sauerkraut?
No. Anyways, try it out. I finally tried out the first time. And you know what? I saw them at the Maxwell Rodeo Parade.
Oh, that's right.
And that's when I was like, oh, yeah. Sometimes I work in Willows. And you know what? They're there.
All I'm saying is, without you describing the burger, like, I'm not enticed to go. It just sounds like a regular burger.
I feel like if you're going to go for the first time, like, go where you can sit down. Because
I thought you couldn't sit. Isn't it standing only?
It's like two areas. They have their bar, which is standing only.
I am thoroughly confused now.
Next to it where they have tables where you can sit.
Quote unquote.
Well,
I don't know. That's it. I'm done. Goodbye, everyone. I'm over this podcast. I'm leaving. Have a great time at the fair parade, street dance, at the derby. All the Colusa County events are happening. I will see you out there. Say hi. I'm out. Bye.
Well, I guess we're done.
Okay. Hayley laid it down. She laid it down.
Thank you all for listening, and I guess we'll see you in the next one.
If she doesn't office first, I guess.
Help.
I think she's hangry. Maybe we just need to get her a Snickers.
For listening to the Backpage Podcast. Like what we do? Share us on Facebook, Instagram, and tell all your friends to tune in. And don't forget to visit our website and show us some love at RadioColusa.com.